I'm making this prediction here and now for the world to see. Google Stadia Base and Pro is coming out tomorrow. If you're interested in Google Stadia news, reviews, analysis from me, don't forget to hit subscribe. Get that bell notification turned on so you stay up to date when my videos drop live every single morning at 7 a.m. Central Standard Time and when we happen to go live, okay? Now, at the very beginning of the video, I mentioned that Stadia Base and Pro will be launching on, well, tomorrow. And where am I getting this idea? Do I have proof? No. But as someone that's, you know, watched television for so long, has watched wrestling for so long, I start to develop theories about why things can happen and how they can happen. And am I right? Usually no. But there's so many things here that are signifying to me personally that, well, maybe, just maybe, this could happen. Let's start off with a community update that just happened, yesterday. Stadia dropped the update that additional phones have officially launched to be able to play Google Stadia, and here's what they said. Stadia is about to play games on way more phones. Beginning February 20th, you can play games on Stadia using a broad new selection of mobile devices. In addition to the Pixel family, Stadia will now support phones from Samsung, Asus, and Razer. You'll also soon be able to play on the brand new Samsung S20 line. More supported phones means you have even more ways to play games when, where, and how you want with Stadia. The complete list of new compatible phones includes pretty much every Samsung Galaxy device that's come out in the last 3 years. That includes the S8 Active and the S10e. Also included would be the Razer Phone 1 and 2 and the Asus ROG Phone 1 and 2. Combined with compatible Pixel 2, 3, and 4 devices, Stadia will let you play games on more than 20 different Android phones beginning February 20th. You can also play on tablets, laptops, desktops, as well as TVs through the Google Chromecast Ultra. Support for these mobile devices begin later this week. Play on a smartphone you already own with Stadia. Whether you're using the Founders Edition, Premier Edition, or Stadia Buddy Pass, enjoy playing on new phones. Now, I've mentioned before that, well, Android devices, well, they're quite popular. Here in America, though, iPhones are a little bit more of a big deal, but across the entire world, that's not the case. So having support for Android is, you know, probably a bigger priority, especially because Google owns Android, if you haven't heard. So makes sense that that's what they're gonna focus on first, okay? So this is a big deal. And I'm gonna go ahead and parlay this into the iOS beta that was recently announced. If you go to previewapps.withgoogle.com, you'll be able to register your Apple device to, well, just a lot of Google beta testing preview apps. First here, you're going to select your Apple device and you can definitely do pretty much as many as you'd like. And you're not going to have literally everything on every single device. So Stadia is not going to be on your Apple Watch anytime soon, if ever, obviously. But go ahead and click your phone, pretend you have an iPhone XS. And from here, you can pick pretty much anything that Google offers when it comes to their applications. But the one we're going to talk about and the one that's the only one that's important here, Google Stadia. And you click next, you'll go here, you'll be able to click your language, even in, you know, countries that don't have Stadia just yet. Click enroll, you read through the terms and service that, you know, everyone does, click accept. And well, that's it. After that, you'll be greeted by this screen, which will show your apps that you have applied to be as a part of the preview program. And from here, just like the xCloud beta program that's currently going on, you're going to be getting yourself into the test flight application that iOS currently has. And you're going to be waiting for a beta code to pretty much go ahead and test it out. Now, as far as I know, no one's gotten that yet. So the registration period has officially started. I don't know where this really came from. I had heard it initially from Ace over at Cloud Gaming X. Go ahead and click the link above to check out his recent video that he did with Meg Atron X. She did a interview with him. It was a fun little sit down conversation, getting to know each other a little bit more. Go watch that. That's where I first heard about this whole possibility of, well, Stadia testing on iOS. So good move on his part by, well, letting us all know, all right? But this is going to come back later as well. We're gonna table that, the Android part, and well, let's go to the next thing. Next thing is all the sales that we're getting. Now, last week we knew about the Borderlands and NBA 2K20 sales, so sales from the 2K side of things. So they make Borderlands and NBA 2K, obviously, and those have been pretty good sales compared to other consoles. I can't really tell you what Borderlands does, but I know NBA 2K is cheaper on Stadia, and if you were worried about competitive pricing between Stadia and the other consoles, I think that can be put to rest, especially when we talk about something called Shadow of the Tomb Raider. Now, if you look at the full list here, because that's going to include Shadow of the Tomb Raider, this actually went on sale the day before the other games that I'll mention here in just a second went on sale, but people that are worried about Shadow of the Tomb Raider's pricing, worry no more, because it's down to $19.80, which is the historical low for Stadia. I believe that was around the $24-$25 mark last time it was on sale. And Kine has officially joined the sales list as well. We thought we were getting that last week when the developer mentioned it, but she was off by a couple days. And she mentioned it was 25% off in the Epic Game Store, and going back to that whole competitive pricing piece, it is cheaper on Stadia. So people worried about that, worry no longer, because Kine is cheaper on Stadia than the Epic Game Store. Moving on, Wolfenstein Youngblood, also down about 33%, down to $20.09. I'm not sure what's up with these weird centages that they're going with. Centage, is that even a word? I don't know. After that, something that might be of more interest to a lot of other people would be Red Dead Redemption 2. Now, if you're looking at just the launch edition, not really too much to really, you know, maybe tip you over to the other side of fence if you're on the fence of should I buy it or no. But if you look into the Ultimate Edition or the Special Edition, that's where you're going to get your most value, and it's by a lot. So if you're interested in getting Red Dead Redemption, I might spend the normal asking price of $60 and get the Ultimate, because you're going to get pretty much $100 worth of stuff for 40% off, and that's where you probably want to go with your money. Now, the thing to definitely note about all these games, if you were interested in, well, predicting next month's pro games, these had some games you might consider immediately guessing. Kine would probably be one, Wolfenstein, Shadow of the Tomb Raider, but all these games you are seeing here go on sale or are on sale until the beginning of March. And when I say beginning of March, I don't mean March 1st, I mean like 4th and the 5th. So it's going to be a couple days into the month, which means you're probably not going to see these on sale still if there's, you know, the opportunity for these to become pro games. I don't know what games we look at instead, but I mean, we can definitely talk about that at another time. This is not really time to predict that, but we're going to predict something else, and let's start rolling into why I think Stadia Base is coming. Because that's what you're here for, right? First, after this word. Okay, no, I don't have sponsors. Come on. I guess I could throw, you know, an ad break here, but that's too easy, right? Welcome back. I did it. I'm sorry. I had to. Okay, so the thing is, I think Stadia Base and Stadia Pro are coming this year because, or not this year, duh. I think they're coming tomorrow because of so many things that have happened recently. And, well, let's for one talk about the elephant in the room. Or, not really. Okay. Well, yeah, it is the elephant in the room. 3 months are up. That's the easiest way to, you know, predict this. That's the way people have been predicting it. The 19th, which happens to be Thursday, right? Is the last official day for Founders, but let's be real, not many people were playing on the 19th because we were still waiting for our Atoms to get here. We were waiting for our Founders packs to get here, which, well, didn't necessarily happen on the 19th. Mine came on the 21st, so it took a couple days past the launch date. So in this window, we're looking at Founders editions finally coming up due, which means we're gonna start getting charged every month, or we cancel it and we're just gonna be on the base tier. So if you'd happened to return your Founders or Premier Edition in the last couple months, you were put on the base tier, so the technology's always been there. So my idea is that, well, these 3 months were used for them to kind of ramp up and see how their servers can handle things, and I think they're ready to unlock it. Because the technology, like I said, has been there, so it's not been a problem of, well, how do we make people be able to get base? We don't have that ready to go. How do we make people, you know, get charged every month? We're not ready for that either. But they are. It's been there. That on its own, I don't think is enough to say that Stadia Base is ready to go. Stadia Free or Stadia Pro is ready to go. I don't think that's not enough to go on, because yeah, they can just keep charging us, or they can just let us keep playing. They're waiting for something more. And here's the thing they're waiting for. They're waiting for the Android phone support. And iOS, is it a big deal in America? Yes, it obviously is. But Android, bigger deal across the entire world, because when it comes to market share across the world, Android phones are going to be your top tier. And in case you forgot, Google owns Android, so that makes sense, right? Now, if Apple had their own service, they'd probably be focused on iOS. That makes sense, okay? So with that being said, the more important factor here is that Android's just, you know, in more people's pockets these days. So they're gonna focus on that. They're going to focus on what they own, obviously, but one of the appeals of Google Stadia was being able to play anywhere, right? And well, it's kind of misleading if you have this free tier, this pro tier, saying, hey, you can play on your Android phones soon. No, you can play them on them tomorrow. That's what they want to do. And you might think, okay, something this big, wouldn't they announce that ahead of time, like Android? That brings me to my next point. Why are they announcing this ahead of time? they usually aren't announcing things ahead of time. Achievements, that came out of nowhere. Controller updates, out of nowhere. Yes, that's not really that exciting, I get that. Sales, out of nowhere. They're not announcing these things ahead of time. They're usually just dropping them out of the sky. So why would they specifically announce that Android support is coming on Friday? Maybe it's because they have something else planned that they're ready to announce the day before. I don't know. Maybe? Because if it's ready to go on Friday, wouldn't you assume it's ready now? Because you wouldn't announce something for it's coming out in a few days if it literally wasn't ready. Like, why Friday? Why specifically Friday? It's because on Thursday, which they've been using as their big announcement, like Tuesday is kind of like their, here's a run-of-the-mill announcement. Although this wasn't really a run-of-the-mill announcement. Android support is huge. That's a big deal. But I think it's the prelude to what is a bigger deal, which is Thursday, which is going to be a shadow drop of Stadia is available for everyone. Go ahead and go nuts. Now, I think they should have a trial attached to that. That's not the first time I've said that. But these are the things that are lining up. Couple that with the fact there are so many games on sale right now. I believe this is the most that have been on sale since, I don't know, maybe the launch of Stadia. Think about that. All the sales, they shadow drop a lot of things. They've announced Android ahead of time. They haven't been doing that. 3 months of Pro are up. All these things are coming together all around at the same time. Something big's happening. And I asked this on Twitter. Do you think something big is going to be announced the final week of the People's Founders Editions coming up due? And it was pretty split down the middle. People really couldn't be convinced one way or the other. But here's the thing. I can. Android support, that's huge. What's bigger than that? Why announce that for the day after Thursday? Because Android support is going to be officially available for anyone that wants to use Stadia. Because Stadia Pro, Stadia Base is going to be available on February 19th, and you can't convince me any differently. Unless you can in the comments. So let me know down below if you think I am wrong or if you think I'm right. I wanna know your thoughts. Let's open this conversation up because I think this would be a great topic to really, really discuss, especially if I am right, when we do Club Stadia Live on Saturday afternoon at about 1 o'clock, I'm thinking. So let me know your thoughts down below. Of course, like this video if you liked it, dislike it if you didn't, and share this with a friend who is interested in Stadia. And well, if you've been trying to convince them to try it, tell them that Thursday, tomorrow, it's coming out. Tell them I said that. And if I'm wrong, don't let them blame you. Blame me. It's all right. I can take the hit. It's fine. But that's my prediction. And I want to be right on this. And I want my word out there. I want to be on the record saying this. And when I'm wrong, I'll say, well, it was a prediction. It wasn't me saying it's happening. So until next time, thank you and party on.